Well, unlike you, that joke never gets old.
Oh, and I forgot to pick up the cake.
Hey, Lois, I don't like any of these snacks. Can I have something from the kitchen?
We can have snacks from the kitchen?
I could go for a sandwich.
No, no one gets snacks from the kitchen.
Last minute work thing. He's always put business first. Even growing up, he never came to any of my piano recitals. It was the 80s, so he was always doing cocaine and sushi business meetings.
All right, Hideki, it's a deal. Now let's celebrate.
Okay.
And here, I brought you a gift.
A gun?
Yeah, you love guns.
No, I don't. You don't know me at all. I can't believe you'd blow off my party, then give me a handgun. Especially.
There's a bunch of them. They gotta be good. No. No. Tom Segura? No. Chinese girl? Another Chinese girl? No. No. Angela.
Okay, I'm off to the grocery store.
So what'd you do with the gun?
Gun?
Yeah, my father gave me a gun as a present yesterday.
Hi, I got my gun here. I'd like to rent a stall, please.
Sure. You need a tutorial before you start?
Yeah, it's a gun range. I think I got it. Wait, I think I did.
In here, the room's pitch dark. I wonder where you are tonight. No answer on the telephone.
Oh, my God, Peter! Give me that! This gun is not staying in this house for one more second. I'm giving it back to my father.
Yeah, it's been a disaster. Like when Peter was the only one not wearing black jeans at a Rush concert.
Daddy? Daddy, are you there? Don't. Take the gun! Serious. They haven't done an overhead crane shot yet. Oh, God! There it is! I'm calling 911! Hoffman, please, how's my father?
Well, at this point, it's hard to say. He suffered severe head trauma. So, if you want to beat him in Mario Kart, this is your chance.
And a champion! On Mad Men, I was Christina Hendricks' bra.
Joan, can you call a meeting of the partners?
Help me! Too much is being asked of me!
At least you're there. I'm John Hamm's underwear.
Why am I Elizabeth Moss's son?
Daddy living here is going to be a big adjustment, and we're all going to have to make sacrifices. So, Meg, Daddy will sleep in your room, and Stewie and Chris, you'll stay where you are.
What? I'm the only one sacrificing.
Don't be ridiculous, Meg. I said everybody.
What? You don't know who this is? But he's so talented. Anyone who doesn't know who he is brings shame on his children and wife.
Peter, come on. We're trying to help Daddy not relive our embarrassing loss to Joe and Bonnie and Celine. NCIS is on, but I want to watch Real Housewives, unless you tell me not to. Oh, those two hate each other. These two have a 3-year-old feud based on an offhanded remark at a charity.
Isn't it? You're starting to see what I'm saying.
Since you're doing a little better, Daddy, I thought you should see where you work. It might help killing 4,000. You bought Vine and shut it down.
I did what?
You bought Vine and shut it down.
I did what?
You bought Vine and shut it down.
I did what?
I'm sorry, Daddy, but you're a very cutthroat businessman. And maybe what?
A cutthroat businessman. But what about when I wasn't at work? What did we do together?
Well, sometimes you made me reenact Kids in the Hall sketches that basically had no endings. All right, let me go to Facebook. It's autofilling Fat Butt Rodeo. Peter!
You were supposed to stay on Firefox.
It's been wonderful spending so much quality time with you.
Yeah, Carter. You know, you've always been a real bastard, but I gotta say, it's nice to see you turning things around.
Thanks. You know, you guys made me realize that I wasted my whole life caring about money, and I'm not giving up another second.
So, it's weird being Japanese. Last night, my husband wanted 69. I said,
wants to spend time with me, and that's more important than any inheritance.
Yeah, well, I still want that money. It's the only way I can afford that surgery to turn myself into 100% stained glass.
I don't get it.
Are you mad? I can't tell if you're mad.
Very mad. This is unacceptable. What's the point of having millions of dollars if everything can't be Superman?
Okay, well, we'll fix it right away. Is there anything else I can get you?
Yes.
Exact moment of completion.
Yeah, Meg, take it down a notch.
I know what'll make him mad. Let's get him a book for Christmas.
Didn't I get you all books for Christmas?
Yeah, and now I've got something for you to read, genius. It's called The Room.
Turn him into one of my kids.
So, what do you want to do today?
You know, this may be crazy, but I'd love Jerry Lee Lewis.
That's it. You shake my nerves and you rattle my brain. Something insane.
Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. You don't have to sing the
Wow, Dad's really taking this to heart.
Meg, tie my shoe.
Hey, let's do another. How about my karaoke song?
Sure. What is it?
The theme to Hill Street Blues.
What? But that doesn't...
That's what made it real.
Hill Street Blues. Hill Street Blues. Hill Street Blues. I got those Hill Street Blues.
What are you doing here? Daddy? Daddy, please tell me you can hear me.
What's going on? And what are you idiots doing here? I can't waste time with you. I'm a cutthroat businessman.
Peter, that show's not on after us anymore.
Oh. What is on? Something as or more successful?
Carlos, y Lupe, y otra Lupe, Salvador, Fabián, Jesús, María, Vicente, y los perros de Vicente.
He was either wounded or killed. I don't remember.
Well, which is it, Stewie? Wounded or killed? I can work with either.
No, he's dead. He's dead. Just like the Pink Panther.
What's wrong with him, Doctor?
Well, it seems his lungs are completely filled with Owens Corning fiberglass insulation.
How long have you been doing magic?
Oh, long time. I used to work with Doug Henning.
Wow.
Yeah, want to see my Doug Henning?
Welcome to the wonderful world of magic. Hope I don't get AIDS.
Oh, God, that is so my humor.
More and I would have ended up in hospital, man.
Oh, you said it, friend. But I wanted to stay, because I almost had sex on this girl.
Oh, yeah, but it was so expensive. Each drink was like
$6.40. Joe.
Really?
Yeah, we'll do all the great tricks. You can even split me in half.
What?
Saw me in half.
Well, I am still a little shaky on some of this stuff. I guess I could use the help.
Great, and we'll get you a wand, a top hat, and a cape. In fact, you can use Peter's cape from last year's Halloween costume.
Magic show, how about a big round of applause for the amazing Brian?
Yay! I can't believe I agreed to 4 costume changes. Oh, who am I kidding? I insisted on it.
Brian, thanks.
The hell with both of you. I'm out of here. Are we doing this thing or what? Brian? Brian? Well, this was a lot of effort for nothing. Like trying to tell Matthew McConaughey how much he sucks. You know, Matthew...
Doing what it is that I do.
Yes, but you're not hearing me. Dazed and Confused was the one thing that was passable. After that...
Oh, thanks, man. That actually launched my career.
After that, everything else was awful. Contact, they didn't even need you in that movie. They could have done the whole movie without... The
matter is, I don't like my movies either, but, man, they just keep offering me money, and I do it, and then I get to go around the world. I mean, did you see Sahara? But I tell you what that movie gave me was an opportunity to take an Airstream all across the country and sell that picture one person at a time.
I just wonder if she'd even want to see me. I wasn't exactly the nicest guy in the world.
And then, in high school, I was violated sexually by my father. It happened on numerous occasions, and I was too afraid to tell anyone because I felt like somehow...
Yeah, it's me.
And all he wants is to kiss you just one more time.
Wow, you sure look different than the last time I saw you.
Yeah, haircut.
So, to get out of here, I just make a left out of the drive. It's a lovely home, Tracy.
That's so weird. It smells like there's a cat, but I bet there's no cat.
I've wanted you to meet Dylan for a long time, Brian.
Well, Brian, a son. How about that?
My God, this is...
And that's how we'll remember you. As a big fart.
Goodbye, big fart. So, Dylan, shouldn't you be in school?
I don't know.
It's Wednesday.
Oh!
Achoo!
Quiet! Keep it down up here! What did I just say? I'm calling the police!
I don't know, Brian. Don't you think you have a responsibility to your son?
Hey, Lois! Dylan! What are you doing here?
My mom wanted me to give you this.
To Brian from Tracy. He's your problem now. P.S. Will you write me a letter of recommendation for the University of Phoenix? No.
Okay, but be careful opening the closet, because that's where the evil monkey lives.
I haven't been in my closet for...
Well, not to get technical, sir, but you are the bastard. Funny or memorable?
I have a pet hedgehog named Zippy, and I shall walk her to town. And each time my foot hits the ground, I shall say boing, boing, boing.
I'm a girl! I don't even like the good Monty Python's.
How to lose a guy in 10 seconds starring Stewie Griffin, huh? Gee whiz.
Hey, Lois, is the air conditioning on? I just woke up from a nap and I feel...
Oh, thanks, Lois. Dylan put this paper bag on my head and I could not for the life of me figure out how to get it off. That kid's a sociopath.
Well, it's time you lay down the law with him.
I couldn't agree more. I think it's best if you just get out of this house.
Fine, I hate it here anyhow. Get out of my way!
My pot!
Your pot?
And then in chapter 28 of my novel... The other...
Yeah, I'm not really looking for notes, but you know, Dylan, I gotta tell you something. I'm sorry I wasn't around when you were growing up.
Don't. Just don't.
If I had known having a son could be like this...
How?
See anything you like, speak up.
Hey there, everybody. Was somebody looking for a son with a bright new path to adult, right?
Yes.
Bye, Mom.
Bye.
All right, kids. Have a good day at school.
Hey, Dylan. Have a great day at school.
Got that ticket because I got distracted because you were leaning out the window barking at a cow.
So you admit you ran the red light?
Fuck you.
Whoa! Not the kind of language I want Dylan exposed to. Have fun with your dead kids, reckless driver.
Transform your uncut trash-strewn lawn into a living canvas that tells passersby, hey, everyone, a real funny bugger lives here. Your neighbors will chuckle warmly, and motorists will slow down and applaud when they cast their eyes on such favorites as sort of Ben and Jerry's.
You know, I just think, oh my God, what if Dylan were on that plane? What? Oh, my God. Oh, I just don't know what I would do. I don't know what I would do.
Yeah, I understand. That'd be tough.
Oh, no. Oh, no. No. Quagmire. No. You do not understand. Overprotective. Now, that's a dad talking. That is a dad talking, Quagmire. You're right. You can't hold your kids back. It's like I say, you have to give your kids both roots and wings.
Brian, I want...
Kitties.
I'm telling you, Joe, he's as annoying as mosquitoes in the summertime.
Can I come in there with you? There's light in there.
No, go away.
Can I please come in? You have
easier than escaping from Canadian Alcatraz.
Can I go out through here? Just be back by bedtime. Okay.
Lunch is ready, everyone. That's it, Brian. Feed him whatever you want. Tell you what, go up to my jewelry box, take my gold jewelry, melt it down, make it into bread, and feed him that. That good enough? Gold bread good enough for you, Dylan?
Hey, everybody! Look, the old you back, that's all.
Look, all right, okay, maybe I have been acting different lately, all right? But that's only because I've truly connected with the one bit of flesh and blood that I have on this earth. And I have no intention of giving that up.
You know, I guess a dad couldn't ask for more than that. I'm proud of you, Dylan. My life will never be the same for knowing you. Goodbye, and good luck.
Goodbye, Dad.